I'm Steve Smith, and I play drums on the original version of Don't Stop Believin'. It's been 35 years since I've explained the various drum parts, and right here is the very ride cymbal that I played. It's been in storage for a long time, but I broke it out, dusted it off, and brought it here to Drumeo. The drum parts on the Journey song, Don't Stop Believin', have four sections. I conceived the idea of the drum parts as a rhythm and melodic accompaniment to the music. I would record what happened in the rehearsal room, and then I'd take those ideas home, listen to them, and work out the parts that I wanted to hear to go along with the song. And as it turned out, I needed to develop some open-handed playing to play the parts that I was hearing first in my head, and then I figured out how to play them on the drums. I didn't necessarily play open-handed, but I developed the ability specifically for the song Don't Stop Believin'. Before I break down the parts that I played on Don't Stop Believin', you can access the note-for-note transcriptions inside Drumeo. There's also a lot of other Journey song transcriptions for the drums at Drumeo. So we have the bass drum part, straight four on the floor. You'll hear the most prominent voice on the kit is the bass drum. So that's the foundation. Very strong, coming from underneath with the snare drum. I'm not playing rim shots. I didn't play rim shots on most of the Journey songs. And that was the direction that a lot of music was being recorded in those years. And very specifically from the producer, they wanted me to just play dead center in the middle of the drum. And the tuning was lower in those years as well. But for the hi-hat, it's just the tip of the stick on the hat. So I'm not playing with the shoulder of the stick. I'm not on the edge of the hats. Just take note of that, because I do see drummers play this tune. And one of the things I notice is they play what I consider too heavy a hi-hat. So my inner balance is clearly bass drum dominant, snare drum a little behind that, and then pretty light on the hi-hat. That's the first part. After that, the second part, I had the idea just to play the bell of the cymbal and just to add the bell one hit on the bell of the cymbal to accompany that pattern. The third part starts with the exact same part as the second part, but I add two more notes on the bell of this 24-inch Ping Ride cymbal. This is the actual cymbal that I did use while recording Don't Stop Believin'. In fact, I use this ride cymbal on most of the Journey records that I played on. And the fourth section, the fourth drum part, is a four-bar phrase. And that comes in with the guitar solo, and the chorus on out. Yeah. There's no question it's a challenging part to play, but it seemed to be a nice musical addition to the song that helped it realize its potential. That was the song that started off the Journey album, Escape, which went on to become a very big selling album at this point. It has a diamond certification, over 10 million copies sold. Right now, I'll play the entire song for you so you can see how all these parts work within the song.
A singer in a smoky room, the smell of wine and cheap perfume. For a smile, they can share the night. It goes on.
Hope you enjoyed that performance and see how all those drum parts worked in support of the song. I have two courses on Drumeo, one called The Art of Drum Soloing, and one of the solos I break down is the drum solo I played on La Do Day. I also have a course called Beyond the Books, which addresses fundamental drum set playing and developing a very wide dynamic range. This is Steve Smith. Hope you enjoyed the program. Take care, and I'll see you down the road on tour.